Blackstone Publishing presents Build Yourself a Boat by Camonghne Felix. This book is read by Camonghne Felix. I'm going look for my body, yeah. I'll be back, like, real soon. Solange Knowles. If ruin was my sole inheritance, and the only certainty, the impossibility of recovering the stories of the enslaved, did this make my history tantamount to mourning? Or worse, was it a melancholia I would never be able to overcome? Sadia Hartman, Lose Your Mother. Lost Poem 4, RX. The psych on duty in triage asks me if I want to die, and I say, not at the moment, no, but stay tuned. I can charm my way out of anything, including his 7-day suggested stay, those ugly gray mornings buzzing in infrasound. I can save my own life just as easily as I can corrupt compounds of ripe silence with just a mouth, drown it out of its own sound. This is what makes me dangerously compatible with death, me and my ability to finesse choice out of desire, the talented tenth of disassociation, the power of being just a body within a body of jewels. Contouring the Flattening. I try not to tell about the stories still bleeding. After all, who wishes to lead their own mother to wolves? I try not to mess with the shape of my privilege. I only say what they need to hear. If the they is an us, I make myself an example. I lie to keep it all intact. But if I felt I could, I would unstitch this plaque sewn over my mouth. I would tell you of the seasonal allergies, how my primary doctor warned my mother of dead cockroaches, their eggs, the likelihood of them in my lungs. I would tell of how often we'd bomb the house, how I'd spend summer nights collecting little brown skeletons in the thousands, every inhale ending in a question of poison. I would tell of the mice that sometimes bit us in our sleep, how the infestation of them violated any concept of domain, how we could not know who the house really belonged to, a house of rodents or of men. But I keep my sob stories to myself. I keep my smile white and my fists closed. I let survival be survival. I grow into the shoe. I keep the world big and my sanity small. I was almost killed in that water, and I've had a fear ever since. Cutting with JB. JB's getting her ass bust in the other room. We can hear the clap-clap of wet flesh over the whip of the ceiling fan above. The heat in the projects is always on and thick and coming for your edges, except for the days when you really need it, when it's 5 degrees with wind chill and housing won't come fix your broken bedroom window. It's 12:30, and by now I'm bored enough to maybe consider going back to school, but they won't let me in this late in the day anyway, so I have to sit with the decision I've made. No one's looking for us. Emmy's mom died 5 weeks ago, so as far as she's concerned, what the fuck is a parent? I've never had a best friend before. All the books say that when your best friend's mama die, you ain't got no parents neither. We spend our days in patient wanderlust, living off sheer probability in a series of cheap, rancid thrills. Imagine my sister, an astronaut? When she was small, I couldn't see her. I held her hand in tendered obligation, fed her because she was hungry, slapped her because she spoke. One day, she stole my underwear. I climbed to the top of our bunk beds, my waist a cradle over hers, my fist a marsh of dead moons shadowing her little face. After two taps, I felt the monstrosity of my putrid desires flatten, my intrinsic knowings suddenly afraid to bruise the small genius, the strange foreign god of sisterhood. It was then I knew I loved her something bad. She's off to college, going to study some aerospace, biomedical, nanoscience shit, some shit only white people think to study because access is a frame of reference and organizing principle. In the family group chat, she sweats us out with her excitement about next semester and 8 a.m. trig. In high school, I failed everything, graduated with underwhelming decimal.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.